outside looking in, you always hear the little gentle ribbings, or, you know, you and Draymond, you can see on TV, sometimes you guys go back and forth. And I don't think it's in a demonstrative way, but you both are competitors. You know what I'm saying? You both are tough guys. How do you manage that relationship with chill minds like Steph and Clay, or sometimes even Dre? He has his moments. But then, you know, you go right back to Draymond where, you know, you guys might punch each other in the chest to show you love each other. Like, do you just wait till, you know, you're on your deathbed for him to say thank you? Or are you just like, or is there a love language that you understand?
No, there's a lot of love there. And you know, it's, we've had plenty of conversations, you know, where he's, you know, told me how much I've meant to him and vice versa. And then we've had plenty of near fights that Andre has witnessed. And, you know, he and I, Draymond and I, are both super competitive. We obviously, you know, show it in different ways. Like, he's much more demonstrative. Yeah. But Andre, you've seen me, like, I'll snap, you know, and I'll, mm-hmm. you know, whether it's breaking a clipboard or whatever, like, I have a tipping point and I am incredibly competitive. And that's one of the reasons Draymond and I butt heads, because when we see something differently and we start butting heads over it, there's no stopping either one of us. And yeah. so mm-hmm. That dynamic has been an interesting one for the team. I think it's honestly been healthy for the team. Yeah. It keeps us on edge a little bit. And I think the last couple of years, it's really softened quite a bit, just because we've been together for so long. We've been through so much. And I respect what Draymond has meant to the team so much and to the group. I think I've learned how to coach him better than I did, say, 5 years ago.